Now go through to reception, Smith. They're waiting for you. Don't look round, just go.
Well, that wasn't very nice, was it, Birdsworth? Going off to Barnhurst like that and not saying goodbye to you? I just don't understand some people.
Bee!
Yes, gentlemen, what can I do for you?
Is there a Miss Judith Bryant living here?
Yes, there is, but I'd rather not disturb her at the moment. She's sleeping upstairs.
I'm afraid we'll have to disturb her. Mr.
Wallace. Why, what's wrong?
I have a warrant for her arrest.
What's the charge?
Murder.
Come on, I want you to stand up. Birdsworth, you heard me. Will you please stand up? Now, come on, just come.
Oh!
Well, what's wrong?
Oh, I'm bugging me up.
Oh, my God. Get Dr. Collins, will you? Come on.
Bee!
Yes, all right, calm down. I want you to try and stand up if you can. Come on. We can't do anything.
She didn't even say goodbye.
Don't hurt yourself.
You stupid, dumb woman. She's not here.
You don't say. She hasn't shot through, has she?
Oh, come on, she's probably down at the shops.
Well, we'll just make sure she hasn't taken a change of clothes with her.
Just a sec. I don't believe I saw your search warrant.
Now, let's keep it friendly, Mr. Wallace.
Taking the words right out of my mouth. Look, the trouble is, we've got some of the women around here a little wary of the law.
You don't say.
Yeah, they wouldn't take too kindly to the fact that I let you search their things without a search warrant. Now, that will save me a hell of a headache explaining to them. Might undo all my good work.
Well, if Miss Bryant ever shows up from the shops, do her a favour and let us know, okay?
Yeah, sure.
Of course, it'll be easier all round if she gives herself up. But we can't ask for miracles.
Beautiful, beautiful flowers.
Oh, I'm thrilled you like them.
Oh, they're for me. Oh, I wonder which one of those wonderful men it was.
Excuse me, Mrs. Powell. Shouldn't Mason be in the dining room?
Oh, yes, I was, Miss Ferguson.
Then hop to it.
Oh, I'm looking for Lizzie.
Yes, where is Birdsworth, by the way?
She's with the doctor at the moment. She's broken her wrist.
Broken her wrist? How?
Get moving, Mason. Otherwise, you'll be doing her jobs as well as your own.
Oh, yes. Yes, I'm just going.
Well, how did Birdsworth break her wrist? Couldn't have been from work.
No. By banging on the security gates when you were escorting Smith out. By yourself.
Mrs. Powell, it would seem that you are suggesting something.
Miss Ferguson, the rule book you are so fond of states that no single officer shall take charge of a dangerous inmate unless accompanied by another officer.
I can handle Smith.
Obviously couldn't yesterday. I consider this a serious offence. Robert's in the dining room?
Yes. Are those flowers for her? Between her and Mason, they're turning this place into a lonely hearts club.
Just send her, Miss Ferguson.
Yes, Mrs. Powell. Before or after the champagne and violins arrive.
That's not like Judy to just up and leave.
Oh, she panicked. Couldn't face being put back in Wentworth again.
Well, I can understand that. It's a dreadful place. I just wish I could help.
Oh, it's all right, love. There's nothing anybody can do.
Well, yes, there is around here at least. You can't run the place on your own.
I am going to have a damn good try, for Judy's sake.
But you can't. There's too much work. Well, I tell you what, I'll stay home tomorrow. I can help you out with a few things.
Hang on. What about this great new job you were telling me about?
Oh, that... It's only factory work, and it's just a triad anyway.
It's still a job.
But this is more important. Oh, I want to help Wally. You've been so good to me.
Yeah, you forget it, kiddo. I mean, you stay employed, get your own life set out. That's what comes first.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Besides, I'll be able to cope. Won't be veggie burgers every night, just every second night.
Oh, what if she never comes back? Oh, Wally, she could hide out for years and years, always being scared.
Ah, she's sensible. She'll be back. Yep. She just wants a little bit of space to work things out, that's all.
Pixie told us about Lizzie. Is she all right?
You'll find out soon enough. I suppose I don't have to tell you who these are from.
They're beautiful.
Hmm. Look, I found this in the staff room. It's not exactly bone china, but it'll hold water.
Thank you.
Petra. I think I don't have to tell you that I don't approve of relationships between prisoners and staff. Oh. Well, come on. Don't want them to die, do you?
No, of course not.
By the way, that note, it hasn't been censored.
Darling, I've always loved you and always will. Please, don't make me wait. There's something I want you to have. It's hidden in the flowers. Please accept it. Now, not later. Scott.
Something else is bothering her.
She's gone. She's gone.
She's gone where?
The screws have shipped her off to Barnard's.
Are you sure? She was only in solitary. Of
course I'm sure. Freak put him in the safe box.
Yeah? Well, that's the best news I've heard all week. Smith was history. It's about time she was put out to pasture.
He was my best man. And I'm never going to see her again.
I don't believe it. Well, what are we going to do now, Lizzie?
You'll do what you always do, of course.
Yeah, that's right. Lap at the heels of the new top dog.
Don't worry, you pretty little minds. I'll take good care of the business. The Queen is dead. Long live the Queen.
Ah. It's great, isn't it? I've just put myself down for 3 shifts in a row.
Dedicated lady.
Tired lady.
Well, I'm not in the market for any overtime this week. Marty's coming home this afternoon.
Great. Enjoy the break.
Oh, we shall. We didn't get much of a chance to celebrate last time.
No, well, who could forget that? Listen, don't go hitting any high spots, will you? Do try and remember you're his mother, not a swinging 20-year-old.
Thanks very much. Just because you're old and tired... Oh, hello, Wally.
I need you, Colleen.
I heard about Hazel. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
How's Judy?
Well, she's pretty knocked out, actually. Can I see Anne? It's important.
Sure.
Surely you're not expected to work, Lizzie?
No. But I've got to keep my eye on things for Pete.
Bloody hell. If she's allowed to have a fan, so am I.
No, Lizzie. Sonia's watching.
We've got our rights. and I reckon Beard wants to stand up for them anyway.
You're right, Lizzie, but she wouldn't want you to play into Sonia's hands either.
Yes, well, let's change the subject, shall we? Mrs. Powell had some lovely flowers today. They're yours, aren't they? The flowers? Did Dr. Collins send them?
Yes, he did.
Oh. Beauty, I knew he'd come good. I mean, I knew he wouldn't give up.
Oh, it's wonderful. I feel just as happy as if they were mine. You're very lucky, Petra.
Yeah, well, luck can change. So why don't you stop bludgeoning and fold those sheets?
Exactly what I was about to do.
Get a load of this. You didn't get that at buy-up, did you?
How dare you?
Give it back. Hey, the dog hasn't just got rocks in his head. He's giving them away.
Petra, you're engaged.
So give it back.
Way, I know someone who can give me a good price on this.
Oh, that's an engagement ring. You can't nick that.
You keep out of this ring.
All right, the game's over. Give it back.
Come on, Sonia, I was going to give it.
No.
I'm glad we've got that settled. You see, I can be very generous, providing we all do as we're told. And we wouldn't want Petra to lose her ring, would we?
Well, the flowers are right. I didn't get a chance to see them.
Gorgeous. In any girl's heart.
Well, that was the idea. Look, can I see Petra tomorrow? Just for a few minutes?
Of course you can. Just get Mrs. Powell to fix it.
Thanks. Well, I better go. Maternity calls. Oh, hi, Wally.
Glad I caught you, Scott. Have you heard the autopsy results?
No.
Well, it's official. Hazel died of morphine poisoning.
Oh, hell. No.
They'll probably be asking you a few questions, you know, seeing as you signed the death certificate.
Yeah, look, I can handle that. It's Judy that's in trouble, isn't it?
Yeah, you could say that. The cops are charging her with Hazel's murder. She's gone missing.
No, that's the worst thing she could do. Surely she knows how much harder that'll make it.
I think she had her reasons, like not wanting to come back to this place.
Yeah, look, I really have to go. Let me know if I can help, okay? Anything.
Sure.
Oh, what a mess. Any idea where she's gone?
I was hoping you weren't going to ask me that question.
Wally, if you'd know, you've got to
I just want to give her a chance, damn it. She deserves it.
Chances are better if she comes back.
Yeah, well, slow down. Look, I know that, and I think Judy knows.
Then why on earth did she go off like that?
Oh, she just wanted a bit of breathing space. I mean, but once she sorts it out, she'll settle down, and I think it's important she does it on her own.
Oh, face facts, Wally. What if the police find her? Where?
My old shack in the hills.
Really before you know. When's the big day?
I don't know. I haven't even told Scott I've accepted yet.
Oh. You take ages, Petra. There's the arrangements to make and the wedding dress to get.
Oh, clumsy, aren't you, Mason?
Oh, don't do that.
Dirty, too. A real little pig.
They've just been washed.
Funny. They don't look clean to me. You better do them again.
Oh, stop it, Phyllis. Just leave her alone.
Keep out of this, teacher. You'll lose your sparkle.
All right, that's enough. Put them back in the washer, Pixie.
B would never do anything like that. B was fair. You wouldn't do it either if B was here.
But she isn't, is she, Birdsworth?
That's right. Never mind, Birdsworth. What we take away with one hand, we give back with the other.
Give what?
Well, one of your old pals will be joining you soon. Judy Bryant. She's wanted for Hazel Kent's murder.
Well, here we are then.
Thanks.
What are we drink to?
After all we've been through, the future.
I'd drink to that.
Old mum would drink to anything.
Really good to have you home again.
Yeah, likewise. Well, I hope you don't mind me crashing here.
Of course not. And this isn't just here, this is home.
Right.
You must be starving. Should we eat here or go down to the pub? And you be careful how you answer that.
Well, eating here would be great, but there's one hitch.
Oh, no, don't tell me. She's about your age and the greatest girl in the world.
Yeah, I reckon she could be.
You're a fast worker. When did you say that ship of yours got in?
Oh, sorry, Mum, I know it's first night home
and
everything.
Oh, well, there'll be other nights.
You don't mind, do you? Oh, I knew you'd understand. Hey, mind if I go and unpack?
Of course not.
Oh, you're the greatest. You know that, don't you? Oh, a bit of a problem. Couldn't iron a shirt for me, could you?
No luck?
Ah, she's been here. Found this.
Well, do you think we should wait? She might be back.
Oh, I doubt it. The cops could trace her here. She'd know that.
Yes, and she's running out of time. They'll be doing a pretty thorough job. What next? A daughter?
Oh, no. That'd be the last place she'd go. No, she wouldn't want Laurie to get a whiff of this.
Oh, I guess you're right.
Wherever she is, she'll be a mess. Gotcha. Where the hell are you?
Honestly, Pixie, I don't know why you bother. Only a cougar to answer an advertisement like that.
No, you're wrong. Oh, well, just listen to this. Although I haven't been married before, I know the most sacred moment of my life will be when I watch the girl of my dreams walk down the aisle.
Oh, God.
Sounds like a real jerk to me.
Oh, you're wrong. I'd like to give a man like this a wedding he'll remember. Oh, and this one too. Oh, look, I can't make up my mind. I think I'll have to meet them all.
It is a good idea to meet someone before you marry them, Pixie.
Yes, well, what'll I say? Can you help me, please?
Now, just don't forget there's a phony in there somewhere, the reporter.
Oh, look, I'll be careful. I can pick a reporter a mile off. I almost married one once. They're all the same. They have these nasty little eyes and they wear their pencils behind their ears.
All right, Pixie. Now, sort out the ones you want to answer. I'll be right with you.
I have. I've decided on six already. Six.
Are you missing B?
Oh, God, yes, of course. I'm really worried about Jude, too.
I wouldn't worry. Look, the freak's just probably trying to stir up a hornet's nest. You know what she's like.
Yeah, I know all that. Jude wouldn't have killed Hayes. They were mates. But if the cops reckon that she did, well, she's going to be in strife anyway, isn't she?
Wow! You look smart.
Yeah, well, you don't get much of a chance to wear anything decent on the ship. Look, Mum, we're just going out to dinner. Wouldn't like to come, would you?
Well, thank you, darling. Yes, I think I will.
Oh, great.
Oh, give me a few minutes to tidy up and I'll be right with you.
Yeah, sure.
It's all right, I'm only joking.
I don't mind, really.
Of course you do. I've no intention of going with you. I was young once myself, you know.
Yeah, well, you'll get to see Jen sooner or later. I'll bring her around sometime.
Good. Don't mean to pry, but where did you say you met her?
Well, she came down to look over the ship with a couple of friends before we sailed, and we got talking. Oh, she's really nice, Mum. Not like the usual sort of chick that hangs around ships.
So you only saw the once?
Oh, yeah, but we've been riding ever since. And now we've got a chance to really get to know each other.
Well, don't keep the young lady waiting. Go on, go out and enjoy yourself. I'll see you later.
Yeah, bye.
Bye-bye. You're getting old, Mum.
Reg Bull. Pixie Bull. Oh, goodness, that doesn't sound right, does it? I couldn't possibly marry a man with a name like that. It doesn't suit mine. Or perhaps I should have given him to Rosemary.
He might be quite a nice bloke, though, Pix.
What would you know, Birdsworth? I thought booze was your specialty, not blokes.
Rotten cow. Can't imagine her with any bloke. She'd bloody freeze him to death.
Just ignore her, Lizzie.
Roland Sampson. Pixie Sampson. Oh, that does have a nice ring to it, doesn't it?
Look, Pixie, I'd say you've got enough here to last a lifetime. How about you starting with that lot?
Oh, but I might miss out on the most wonderful man of all creation if I don't read them all.
Well, he might already be there. Come on, start writing or we'll never get through them all.
All right. Well, what'll I say?
We'll let them know what the visiting hours are for a start. Oh, you better give them separate times. You don't want them all showing up at once.
Yeah. And tell them you got good teeth and plenty of wedding dresses.
All right. Well, how's this? My dearest Roland, I received your lovely letter and I think we will make a wonderful couple. I can just imagine walking towards you in the loveliest lace wedding dress, holding a beautiful bouquet of tiny pink rosebuds.
Wentworth wedding bells!
Come on, Pixie, we have to pack up. Maybe you can write a few before night.
Oh, it's going to be so beautiful.
Yeah, what's going to be beautiful, Mason?
Oh, nothing, Miss Ferguson.
All right. Now clear that mess away, otherwise it'll be very ugly.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Well, Birdsworth, won't be long now, will it? Your old mate, Bryant, will soon be in here to give you all the sordid details about how Kent and Daniels died.
Bitch nicked me new bra, the one that makes you look bigger.
Oh, look, would you stop harping on about it? Oh, look at it, we can't eat that.
Oh, what's going on here?
Oh, Pauline nicked me bra and I paid a bloody fortune for it too. Made me look like I really had something.
They started fighting about it while they were cooking tea. Look what happened.
Oh, you got to talk to the bitch, Wally. Tell her to give it back.
I'll take care of the bra, you take care of the dinner, all right?
Oh, good one. Let's go.
We got any eggs?
Yeah, I think so.
Good. We'll have Spanish omelettes.
Oh, Wally, I wanted everything to be so nice.
It's not the end of the world. It's just a few burnt pots. Mm. Any news from Jude? That's more important.
No, nothing. Oh, but it's only been a day. We can't give up yet.
No, you're right. You're right. Let's clean up this mess. Yeah. Get some food. I'm starving.
Yeah, I'm glad Bill isn't here. It would have been awful.
Bill?
You know, Bill Williamson from up near our place.
Oh, right.
I rang him up. He's coming over for tea tomorrow.
Good. He'll have to cook up something special. Show him what a whiz you are in the kitchen.
So let's practice on Spanish omelettes.
Right.
B was my best friend. We've been together so long. It's just like losing my arm. Or me leave, not having her around anymore. She always did what was best for us. What did I do? I went along with that bloody freak.
Lizzie, you didn't have any choice. Well, nobody does with them.
No. I didn't have any guts. She was top dog and we should have stuck by her. Then that bloody Sonia wouldn't have got where she is. I'm an old woman. I can't stand all these changes. Big, odd. Now Jude coming back after all this time.
Who's that?
Oh, God.
What's the matter?
Shut up, Mason. I'm going for a walk.
What did I do?
Just shut up, Birdsworth, and get on your feet.
But I haven't done anything, Miss Pearce.
Can't move.
Where are we going,
Miss Pearce? Get out. Come on, Birdsworth. Out. You must have heard the noises too.
What? Oh, yes, it seemed to be coming from in there. I thought I'd better take a quick look.
Oh, it was probably me you heard crashing about. Oh. I nearly got one of them.
One? What are you talking about?
Rats.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think there's a family in there. I saw one. Huge, big animal. Oh, teeth like razor blades.
Oh, teeth.
Do you want to help me track him down?
Oh, no, thanks.
No, prisoners I sometimes know about, but rats, well, I'll leave that to the experts. Oh, no offence.
That's what I had in mind.
Bloody hell! What about us?
Hello, Mum. I thought you'd be in bed by now.
Oh, no. You know how it is with all the shifts I work. You get used to odd hours. I sometimes find it hard to sleep.
Oh, yeah? Weren't waiting up for me by any chance?
No, no, of course not. Well, you're old enough and ugly enough to look after yourself.
Well, aren't you going to ask me?
Ask you what?
Well, how it went, of course. Oh, Mum, Jen, you won't believe her. She's fantastic.
Good old Super Jen, eh?
Oh, she's sweet. Kind of old-fashioned, I suppose. She's got a great sense of humour and bright...
And you like her.
Oh, she's the greatest.
Well, when am I going to meet this amazing lady?
Oh, tomorrow night. I've invited her here for dinner. Oh, you don't mind, do you?
No, no, of course not. I can hardly wait.
I was out and
I might have known I couldn't trust you, no booze, Birdsworth.
But he was down at the local, getting
extremely... Get in there. Get her to bed, Mason, and get her sobered up.
How did you like that one?
Just try and be quiet, Lizzie.
Hey, look what I got. I was as hungry as sailors when I...
Is everything all right, Miss Ferguson?
Yes, Mrs. Barry. Birdsworth was, she was having a nightmare.
Oh, dear. Do you think I should
No, I wouldn't wake her now. She'll be all right. She, said that she dreamt she was drunk.
Well, yes, that's what I heard. Oh, you know, she's probably upset about Smith. They were very close. I don't know. What with rats and Lizzie making all that racket, it's a wonder the whole prison isn't awake.
Yes. Well, look, why don't we go and have a cup of coffee?
Oh, good.
I don't think there'll be any more disturbances tonight. Should all be quiet now till the morning.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know why you had to turn the tap on so hard anyway. Nearly wet me plaster.
Your plaster, the screw seal like this will be history.
Oh, your bloody mate screw that made me do it.
You know, just brick and then around. Now, look, you'll be
all
right when you've had some
brekkie. Oh,
brekkie! Oh, you're missing. Oh, jeez. Hey, what's the matter with Lizzie? Mind your business, teach.
Lizzie?
No, I'm all right.
Of course she's all right, because what? I'm looking after her. Now, break it up here right before Barry starts sniffing.
And since when have you worried about Lizzie?
I always look after my girls, especially the silly ones who make mistakes.
Come on, everyone, hurry it along here. What's wrong?
Nothing, Mrs. Barry. Lizzie's arm's playing up.
Oh, Officer Barry?
Yeah. Well, if she's only half the things Marty says she is perfect.
Oh, he'd rate her at least 12 out of 10. Oh, I've got the butterflies. I'm going to be a nervous wreck before tonight.
Well, I'd be more worried if he didn't want you to meet her. She sounds like a nice sort of a girl.
That's the problem.
You're joking.
It's my working in a place like this. Mightn't go down too well. You know what some people are like.
You really are worried, aren't you?
Well, of course. I've never met one of his girlfriends before.
Well, just be yourself. She's probably just as scared of you. He might have rated you 12 out of 10 as well. Oh, morning, Joyce.
Morning.
You're on double shift, aren't you?
Yes, afraid so. Still, I can't complain. Last night wasn't too bad.
Oh, good. I thought there might be a few hassles with Smith gone. Certainly didn't think they'd take that lying down.
No, well... Everything was all right. Poor old Lizzie had a bad night, but apart from that, nothing. Mm.
Must be hard for her. They'd been together a long time.
Yeah, too long. Let's hope it isn't the lull before the storm. Oh, don't take too long with that. You've got a classification meeting in a couple of minutes.
All right, Sonia, what's going on?
I beg your pardon?
You saw Lizzie. It was a hangover, wasn't it?
I told you before. Keep out of what doesn't concern you.
Lizzie concerns me. We're talking about an old lady with a heart problem. It could kill her.
She'd do well to remember that. You're asking a lot of questions, Petra. Isn't that unwise?
I'm not going to stand by and see that poor old lady get hurt.
You do as you're told, like all the others.
I wouldn't be so sure of that.
Listen, my dear. I asked you to come in with me and you refused. So keep out, because you've got a lot to lose if you don't.
And what's that supposed to mean? You'll have me beaten up?
No, nothing quite so crass. I detest violence. You're hoping to marry that doctor friend, aren't you?
Try again, Sonia. That's something that's right out of your control.
Is it? I do have some powerful friends.
Not that powerful.
Well, I wouldn't be so sure. My last request was dealt with fairly smartly. Who do you think got rid of Beastman?
Chrissy cards with greetings, without greetings, with snow, without snow, you name it and we've got it.
They look really pretty. Well, what do you want me to do, Mr. Forsyth?
Just coming to that, lovey. Righto, Fred, nip over and help Joe, will you?
Sure.
Right, now you stand here, you stamp the packet, and you stick them in the box.
It's easy enough.
It's a piece of cake. Go on, now have a go at it. That's a ticket. You'll be able to do it with your eyes closed in a couple of hours. Well, I'll see you after.
So it looks as though Judy will be back with us. The police will catch up with her sooner or later.
It's dreadful. It'll destroy her.
She should have thought of that before.
I'm concerned for us as well as for her. With Smith gone, I think perhaps the woman may want her to take over as top dog.
Well, that wouldn't be too bad, would it? I mean, she'd be a good influence.
If they left her alone, yes, but I'm worried about a power struggle.
Haven't been any signs yet.
Well, they're not likely to leave the position vacant for long, so be prepared. Another likely contender is the prisoner we're getting from Barnhurst.
Oh, terrific. Anyone we know?
Cass Parker. She was serving a term for manslaughter until she killed an officer. So be very careful.
Oh, God. I've got a bloody great helmet thumping in my head.
Look, why don't you ask Dr. Collins for something, Lizzie?
Oh, that wouldn't do any good. Care of the dog that bit me might. All he'd do is give me a couple of aspirin.
Okay, ladies, pick your numbers for the day. I've only got a few left.
Oh, bugger it. That's all I need.
Yeah, you got 8 and 23.
Bloody bitch.
What about you?
B was better.
I pass.
You can't do that. It's not in the rules.
I'm not interested.
You should play by the rules, Petra.
I'm not interested in your stupid games.
Then you'll find yourself in a lot of trouble.
All right.
Yeah, you got 12. Roberts, you've got a visitor.
Oh, it was Dr. Collins. Same, I thought the flowers were beautiful.
The minute I thought you was going to stand up to the ice lady.
I don't think anybody will know, Lizzie.
Didn't you like my present?
It was beautiful.
You are going to marry me, aren't you?
I don't think I've got any choice. The women would kill me if I said no.
Did you hear that, Mrs. Powell? It's champagne time.
Well, I forgot to bring it with me. Congratulations.
Thanks. Never mind, we'll seal it with a kiss, if that's okay. We're going to be really happy. You know that, don't you?
I love you, Scott.
Right, I'll get the ball rolling. See the governor, speak to the department.
No, but they mightn't agree.
Nonsense. You know how good I am at getting people to come around my way. Look, Wentworth's going to have the wedding to end all weddings. That is, if that's what you want, to be married in here. I know it's not exactly what we planned.
It's what I want.
Mr. Forsyth, can you help me for a minute? It's going too fast.
Okay, lovey, but you'll have to learn to do it on your own.
Oh, thanks. I'm sure I'll get the hang of it soon.
There you go. Just move those hands a bit faster, okay? That's all there is to it. There you go. You'll be right.
An awful mess.
is a bit, isn't it?
Look, I'll clean it up right away.
Well,
You don't want me to clean it up, do you, Mr. Forsyth?
Ever thought of taking up office work, lovey?
Birdsworth, cigarettes, soap and shampoo.
Oh, beauty, I'm dying for a fag.
I thought you was dying from too much booze. Your insides must be like a rusty can.
Oh, Officer Barry, we seem to be missing a box. I wonder if you'd mind going and having a look for me.
Oh, yes, of course, Miss.
Thank you. Okay, Mason, what have we got here? Shampoo, biscuits and talc, eh? Looks like your brand, Stevens.
Thanks. 10 points for taste, Pixie.
Hey, what's the big idea?
Excuse me, Sonia, that's my shampoo. Well, my hair gets awfully dry if I use anything else.
So does mine.
Roberts, we've got soap, biscuits and coffee. Very nice. I'm sure it'll clash with those lovely flowers of yours. Hunt, you look as though you could do with it.
Ah, Miss Ferguson.
That's not fair. We need those things.
Talking back to an officer, eh? That's going to cost you more. Stevens. There you go. Oh, Hunt, I think you better take those cigarettes off Birdsworth too. They're very bad for our health.
What?
Oh, ladies, that appears to be that. Maybe Mrs. Barry will find you some more.
I bet she pinched the whole bloody lot.
Something worrying you, Birdsworth? No, Stevens, I want to see you. Outside.
Bloody thieving mongrels. And you give me back my fags, you rotten bitch.
Your fags? They can't be. I just got them at buyer.
We paid for that stuff.
What, do you want to take it up with the freak? I'll give her a yell if you like.
And I've taken care of Roberts.
Well, mission accomplished. You know, they fall down like a pack of cards without Smith.
Yeah. However, there may be another problem.
What's that?
A new one coming from Barnhurst. Flash temper and the strength of a man.
You suggesting that she might try and take over?
Maybe. And if she does, she won't be easy game. She killed an officer. One of the toughest in the service.
All right, I'll tread gently. But just remember, I like what I got here and nobody's going to take it away from me.
Oh, yes, you now have 20 minutes and 10 seconds before they let you out of here.
Told you I'd be a nervous wreck before the day was out.
Let's hope we're not all nervous wrecks by tomorrow. Well, this, if I am not mistaken, is Cass Parker. Any trouble?
No, none.
Good. Okay, Parker, stand on the white line.
Oh, I know all that stuff. I've been inside, you know.
Thanks. Just leave those there. Your name is Cassandra Parker, is that correct?
Yep. Only you can call me Cass if you like. Most of me mates do.
You have been charged with 2 counts of manslaughter and will serve the rest of your sentence at Wentworth Detention Centre, is that correct? All right, Parker, it's time for your shower.
Hey, what'd you say you was called?
I didn't, but I am Mrs. Powell, the Deputy Governor.
Pleased to meet you.
Mrs. Powell, I'll take her through if you like. You can get on with your paperwork.
Oh, well, if you're sure, Miss Ferguson. Go on, Parker.
Oh, I hope he's got a uniform will fit me. Busted out of me last one as soon as I moved my arms.
The only way I can imagine her killing someone is if she hugged them to death.
You'll learn every rule in this book by the morning.
Ah, shouldn't be too hard. Probably the same as the ones at Barnhurst.
First thing to remember, Parker, is that this is not Barnhurst. We run a very tight ship here.
Yeah, it's real nice too.
Okay, make your bed. Be quick about it.
Freak's probably giving our tucker to her mates, too.
Yes.
Oh, g'day. Cass Parker. You my new cellmates?
Oh, well, pleased to meet you, Cass. I'm Pixie Mason and this is Lizzie Birdsworth.
Pleased to meet you both.
Is this your first time in prison?
No, I'm from Barnhurst. But I got in a bit of bother up there, so they shipped me out. Chuck, don't mind, but seems an okay sort of joint.
Barnhurst. Our best mate's just gone there. B-Smith.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I heard she'd showed up. Hey, top dog round here, wasn't she?
Yeah. Best mate anybody could ever have. You're sitting on her bed.
Oh, geez, sorry. Well, yeah, I mean, that's where they put me. Look, I don't want any strife. One of yous can swap if you want.
No, it's all right. You look as though you could fill it. She looks pretty tough. Just the sort we need to fix those bastards.
So awful, Wally. Those horrible things just kept coming and coming. Never feel happy about opening a Christmas card again.
Well, next Christmas, I'll send you a birthday card. How about that?
Oh, at least Mr. Forsyth didn't yell at me, and he did give me a week's pay.
Good. You'll find your niche in life. I bet none of the other girls at that factory know which end of a cow to milk.
So what? It's not doing me much good, is it?
Or a good cook's, which reminds me. What's on the menu for tonight?
Oh, I don't know. I was thinking of skipping tea.
And what's Bill supposed to do? Bring his own?
Bill? Oh, no, I'd forgotten he was coming. I haven't even worked out to cook or anything.
Well, just as well I got a couple of steaks out there that'd feed an army.
Oh, thanks, Wally. Look, I'm just going to go and have a quick shower.
Ah, Hunt. I've got a little job for you.
What's that, Miss Ferguson?
You're going to pay a visit on the women after lights out.
How am I going to do that?
Oh, I'll let you in. Then it's up to you to wake them and have a little chat. Remind them that their top dog has gone and they need protection.
Protection against what?
Just $2 a week, Hunt. That's cheap rates for health benefits. They'll love it.
Some of the women haven't got much cash, Miss Ferguson.
Yes, and I've made allowances for that, Hunt. There are other things they can do. Like inform on anyone who's against Stevens.
Geez, I don't think anyone will lag, Miss Ferguson.
Yes, they will. Smith's reign is over, Hunt. There are new rules now, and you're going to help see that they're obeyed, aren't you?
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Good. Now, I've paved the way for you. There shouldn't be any trouble.
What about that new Sheila? She looks tough.
Ugh, she's as thick as two planks. You won't get any trouble there. From now on, Hunt, it's smooth sailing all the way.
Right, well, doesn't look too bad. Serviettes.
Hi, Mum, we're here. Come and meet the most wonderful girl in the world.
Pleased to meet you, Jenny.
To give me roses, I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain us too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare. When morning comes around.